How to tell if a Zener diode is bad. Hey guys! In today's video, I will show you how to test a Zener diode with a multimeter. On your multimeter, you want to set it to the diode setting. Press the red function button to switch it from continuity to diode mode. On the multimeter, the red probe represents the positive terminal, while the black probe represents the negative one. Place the red probe lead on the anode and the black probe lead on the cathode. With a regular Zener diode, the voltage drop typically ranges from 0.6 to 0.7 volts. Our measurement is approximately 0.7 volts, which is a good sign. If you reverse the probe leads to test the reverse bias voltage drop across the Zener diode, you should get OLR overload. To check the voltage across a Zener diode, you can place it on a circuit. This setup requires a power source and a resistor. In this diagram, we have a 9-volt battery as the power source, a 5.1-volt Zener diode, and a 1000-ohm resistor. In this circuit, we have the input voltage of 9 volts, and the Zener diode of 5.1 volts. In a few minutes, you will see 3.9 volts flowing through the resistor. This is because the voltage of the resistor and the Zener diode should add up to the voltage of the battery. To see the voltage across a Zener diode, we will use the help of a breadboard and a multimeter. Connect the red jumper wire to the breadboard marked with the plus sign. Connect the black jumper wire to the breadboard marked with the minus sign. Bend the wire ends of the resistor downward so you can connect them to the breadboard. Connect one end of the resistor to the same column as the red jumper wire. Connect the other end of the resistor on the same row. In this setup, we have the resistor connected to row 12. Gently bend the wire ends of the Zener diode so you can connect them to the breadboard. Now connect one end of the Zener diode to the same row as the resistor. Connect the other end of the Zener diode to the same column as the black jumper wire. Connect the red jumper wire to the red alligator clip. Connect the black jumper wire to the black alligator clip. We will use a 9-volt battery for the power source, but you can use other battery types. On the other end of the red alligator clip, connect it to the positive terminal of the battery. On the other end of the black alligator clip, connect it to the negative terminal of the battery. On the multimeter, turn the dial to the DC voltage setting. Now it's time to check the voltage flowing through the battery. Touch the red probe lead to the red alligator clip and the black probe lead to the black alligator clip. As we expected, the voltage is around 9 volts. Let's turn to the Zener diode. Touch the red probe lead to the cathode end of the Zener diode, and the black probe lead to the anode end of the Zener diode. The voltage is around 5.2 volts. Very good. Now touch the red probe lead to one end of the resistor, and the black probe lead to the other end of the resistor. The voltage is around 4.1 volts. I hope this video has shown you how to test a Zener diode with a multimeter.